Now that I'm here, I just want to check out what's cracking. So let's see. What do I have going here? What do I need? I don't know. Making a lot of money. I'm still populating. I don't know whether to put a nice little park over here in this big section where the road is sticking in. Or I don't know. We kind of should upgrade the roads and... Can I hate the fact that this road is sticking in? Alright, so let's see. Oh, so this is straight. Okay, yes. Okay, so the plan here is to put in a residential here and here's. And one here, so I'll put a commercial here. And that's it, my city is now full. All I have to do now is add a community college down in this little corner, and inside the middle here, I'll add in a university. That way, this region can have a fully funded thing going. Although there's a university over there, but still though, Population Vista will be the smartest city in the region. Because so far, what's going on? Not much is going on. Okay. So let's go ahead and put this into llama speed and make sure that things is going on. Oh, seems there are some uneducated Sims in this area. So let's go ahead and put some schools in. It's kind of funny. Eventually you would think that this area would be green, and these Sims would be able to get up off their feet and walk to school, but it seems no, they need a bus. Okay. Okay, sweet. Even though there was some that's overlapping, I guess that's okay. I guess. Don't take my word for it. See, some of my residents are now leaving the city to go to work at Nugget Plateau. Gibberish. I'm talking gibberish. It's kind of funny that you don't see the billows of smoke going on a population overlook. I would figure. Petition to build a mayor's house is approved. Oh, good day. Should I put the mayor's house? Mayor, put in your house, mayor. Put in the mayor's house. You know, everybody stays happy because they put in the mayor's house. Now hiring. What am I supposed to be hiring at my house? Maids? Dishwashers? Cooks? What is this? I'm supposed to be hiring Sims for my house. Maintain an approval rating of 70% or more. Have a population of 10,000 so far. Pretty good. I see it brought in the land value and people want to start growing. It's pretty good. Okay, now that some of my buildings burned down, and clean up the mess. Does anybody got any marshmallows? Let's make some s'mores. Crap, look at that. Even my houses get burned down. What's going on? Okay, I had enough. I don't wanna see this anymore. But now that my city's in the green, and I'm up by 2,000, 3,000 residents, I think. I don't want to say full, but 3,000 or so. I think I can leave this city to burn for a little bit while I go into what? So I did population overlook, population vista, and I'm gonna go to Chilislilian, Chalician Mons. I kind of want to claim the city that's across the street from me. But I want somebody to take this over and put an education system and some like cops. Mustang Run. Somebody needs to claim this. That's a lot of coal and stuff. So far, Luigi or Marvin. Got Miner's Point. I got this city. So let's go into this city view and take a look at it. So basically, let me show you what happened. It was like, go into trains. So there was a rail line that's coming out from like this, and it kind of went all the way over here, all the way over here, and then it made a curve, and then it came to this station. But the way that the rail line was designed was like so poor. It was like cheesy. And then there was another rail line that was just like basically coming out this section, and it came out through here, and it ended up over here. So being that I like the way the train stations were positioned at, I decided to keep it. But the way that the rail design that was going on, I didn't like it. So I like made it neater. As you can see, it makes a pretty cool, nice and curvy. It reminds me of like the regular SimCities, you know, for the Super Nintendo. Basically, you get this little train thing going. So this is basically what the user had. Basically a little dump here, and he didn't have the ventilations. I actually added that in because there was like a lot of garbage and it was piling up my city that was causing havoc. So I decided to put in some incinerators. This setup was already here, but with dirt roads, I decided to just upgrade some of these right here. It was a great design. The user did have these buildings over here. I decided to add a little bit more. Decided to put a little, I don't know, more houses here, city hall over here. I kind of just like kept it the way it was. Although the roads were poorly designed, I revamped it and I'm making money now. It's not bad. So I really don't have to do much of anything in this city but just show you around and how it is. I decided to put a solar power plant because I'm providing power to my other city, which is Painted Point. So as you can see, I am selling 38 megawatts of power to my other city. So I thought, why not build a solar power plant for that city? And since I'm generating 108 megawatts, the 38 or the 30 that I'm selling to myself ain't that bad. So basically, having this coal power plant just runs my city while having this solar power plant is providing power to Painter's Point, which is right there across from me. Now that I showed you everything and there's like a bunch of traffic piling up, basically, yeah, I thought I would just go ahead and make some money coming here and show you all the cool stuff that's going on. As you can see, the blood is running in the city pretty strong. Power and everything is going great. If you're probably wondering what's this extra rail all about. Well, I kind of built that because I thought about moving the train station from this side to the other. And being that there's industrials here and there's a trade depot here, I thought I would just go ahead and build a train port here where this train station's at. And yep, so that way I could provide trade by rails. Let's tear down some of these abandoned buildings. As you can see, I do have homeless people. And the reason why is because I have a park right next to the police station and stuff. Well, I got two parks. So, yes, I do got homeless peoples. I kind of don't need these water towers, but yes, I think I could just turn them because they're costing me money, and I do have a water pumping station next to a sewage treatment plant. Now, in previous videos, you probably might wonder, hey, yeah, he did say that there was going to be another video about why he has this here. And definitely I will tell you that, and that will be saved for another video. So now that I showed you this city and how I'm making money here, I'm going to go to Painter's Point. So the city was purely designed, purely designed. The roads were crooked, everything was like nasty. And this is basically what you got. So there was a garbage dump here. And being that I removed it, it caused ground pollution. You can see there's still ground pollution signs everywhere. So I decided to go ahead and put some low residentials and commercials to get rid of all that ground pollution. Within time, it does happen. There is one ore mining. I found all the resources that were available to me here, so I decided to put ore miners to work. I got a trade depot. It holds nothing but ore. There is coal, but not enough, and so I just didn't bother to do that. Like I said, the city was poorly designed, that this avenue was already here from the beginning, and I decided to go ahead and use that avenue and decided to make a box. So I made a box, and in this box, I decided to go ahead and make some roads and redesign this whole city. Now, I am making money, as you can see. and I have a great school. One on the station, police precinct, and a hospital. Something that you don't see in most cities very much. I got a park and my mayor's house, which is right here. Pretty good. So my city's pretty much growing. I'm waiting for 40,000. Build my mayor mansion over here. Build probably once I get everything set up. Probably build a community college over here. So this is basically what I got going. So now that I showed you this, let's go ahead and see what's going on. Not much. So far, so good. Let's see about any abandoned buildings. Just one. Probably in low residentials, just like I thought. Alright, homeless people, you can hide around the back of my house. Cool. I'm about 150 residents away from getting my next upgrade for City Hall, which is pretty good. So I guess I'll go ahead and stick around for that. If not, I'll go ahead and move on, because really there isn't anything here for me to do. So far I just want to make some income. I'll speed things up to Llama just to make sure. Oh, look at that, I can upgrade. Fireworks burning, protesters running. Oh my gosh, havoc! Cool, church bells ringing. Upgrade. Okay, now that I showed you this other ruined city, let's go to the final city. The city where I'm telling you I'm having a little bit of trouble. But I call this Moneybag City. So pretty good. Now you come into my city, where basically I'm almost hitting my goal for 100 cap. Now basically this city runs on pure high taxes, and it's being funded by oil. Now my smart population cap is on its 2, going on 3. As you can see, I have 3,444 children that need schooling. I got a great school here, I got a high school here, and I got 2 great schools over here. I also have libraries, something that you don't see in other cities, or basically any of my other cities, which is libraries. But being that this is an oil city, I thought, why not have higher education, being that oil is being the number one source of fundage. As you can see, my oil well over here is causing a lot of ground pollution, and that's okay, because sooner or later these oil wells are gonna run out. So as you can see, the ground pollution that's being created there is telling me that the oil is almost about the depleted age. I got a suburban area over here, which is run by medium to high wealth. I also got some low wealth. And being that this area is low wealth, is because of this. I don't want to go ahead and jeopardize the health of my Sims by creating it high to medium wealth, so I'll just go ahead and keep it low. I do have an industrial factory, which is these two. And these two. I don't want to choose. So basically, the way that I found this city was just pure in blocks. We had little square boxes, as you can see in this area. I decided to keep them because it reminded me, it gave me a lot of remembrance of when I played the Super Nintendo version, and it had these little, whenever you plop the RCI or blocks, you get this blocks of squares. So I thought that was pretty cool, and I decided to keep it. I redesigned it, and I extended the rails, because I do have trade depot or trade port. Basically, like I said, oil is my source of income for this city. If you basically are in peril and cannot maintain your city on just pure RCI, as you can see, I have a lot of varieties of RCI. So it's just basically R and C that's maintaining my city, and a little bit of I, in which you can't see because it's mainly D-zoned. But they are growing, so it's kind of funny. And they are making me money, which is also kind of weird. So yes, this city is barely making its minimum wage of income. As you can see from my other cities, I am making by the thousands. Here I'm just making it by the hundreds. But yes, I am providing power. As you're probably also wondering here, what's this little microchip here on the corner of your city that you have here? Well, I'm kind of selling power to Somethingtopia. And there you go. I'm selling, wow, 0.3 megawatts of energy. So basically, my city needs about 84 megawatts to run, or probably 85 if you want to round it off. The cap that I have is 180 megawatts. 96 megawatts is my excessive use, so I have these 96 megawatts just in case my city decides to grow and I want to make bigger buildings and decide to require more power. I have the capacity to provide them with that, so it's pretty cool. So basically, there you have it. I basically showed you all of the cities that I took over in continuous mode. I'm gonna go ahead and back into population overlook, and I'm gonna leave you there. I gave you a continuous play of how I took over these cities and how I revitalized them, or whatever you might want to take as. And yeah, I will keep you updated on my progress. And as you can see, population overlook has now had its fires extinguished. Thank you to the city of, what is this? Whose fire truck is this? Thank you, Dub City 2, for providing me with your fire services. So shout outs to Dub City 2 for helping me in my earthquake disaster. So, recap, as you can see, I'm making a lot of money revitalizing cities and regions. As you can see, the region is making money, and it is making a large population, so hopefully we can submit ourselves into the challenge and win. What's cool about it is that I just provide you with cool details of how I'm going within my five cities here, and how I'm doing with the neighboring cities. So, yep, Thanks for watching. Enjoy. Post comments or whatever you like. And let me know. So till then, thanks for watching. And see ya.